Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. And in this video, we're gonna see AIDL interfaces. What is the use case of AIDL interfaces and how we can share the functionality of one application to other application using AIDL interfaces. What is AIDL? The full form of AIDL is Android Interface Definition Language, and the main purpose of AIDL interfaces are to perform inter-process communication. Let's take a very simple scenario to understand the use case of AIDL. Suppose you have two applications, your server app and your client app. In this server application, we will define our AIDL interface, give the implementation of that function which present in this interface with the help of service. Client application attached to the service, perform the task. So this is a very simple use case of our AIDL service. Now you might ask, what is the difference between content provider and AIDL interface, because both are using inter-process communication. So the main purpose of content provider is to expose your database operation, basically CRUD operation, so that the other application can consume those database things and perform the logic. Whereas AIDL interfaces are used when you want to perform complex operation, when you want to perform synchronous, asynchronous operation. So let's see with an example how we can use AIDL interface in our project. So let's get started. So first thing first, this is our server application, and in this, go to build gradle kts file and enable AIDL. In your build feature closer, just add AIDL true, and on the top I'm going to use here a plugin, and the plugin name is Kotlin Parcelize. Sync your project. Now it's time to create our AIDL interface. So go to Kotlin plus Java package, right click, new AIDL file, give the name whatever you want, for me it's fine, click on the finish. So this is our interface, and in this interface I'm gonna define few functions. So first function is actually used to calculate sum of two number. Next, we are having a function which is used to get the message. And lastly, I'm gonna use here Parcelable data class. So for that, we require a data class. So let's create that. Make sure the package structure is the same. Gaur Himansu AIDL app. So here, Gaur Himansu AIDL app. And in this package, I'm gonna create my data class. And the data class name is dummy, that has two parameters. First we have name, next we have age, type is integer, and also just use here Parcelable interface, and on the top Parcelize annotation. Go back to your AIDL interface. So in order to tell our interface, we will use here Parcelable keyword and tell the data class name that we will use in this interface. Now we are good to go with our dummy data class in our interface. So dummy, name of this function is transformation. Simply pass your dummy in here. So make sure to use a variance in this, because we are passing that dummy in our interface. Okay, so that's it for our interface. Now just clean your project and rebuild it so that all the necessary code is generated. Okay, so here you can see this is our generated folder. Now we are going to implement all of these functions. So go to your Kotlin plus Java package, and here in this AIDL, I'm gonna create a class, and the class name is my service. Extend this class with service, override on bind. On the top, I'm gonna create a variable binder. Object, now it's time to implement our my AIDL interface. So my AIDL interface stub, use here all the functions. So for the calculate, I'm simply using here a plus b. For the message, you can pass the message whatever you want. For me, I'm using a return connect. In the transformation, I'm gonna create one more object of dummy. In its name, I'm using the incoming dummy name, and add here transformation. Convert this thing into a string. Next we have age, so dummy dot age plus 18. If it is null, then I will return 0. So this is my implementation. Simply return your binder object from here. Go to your Android manifest and register this service. Within our application tag, just use your service, pass your service name. Exported is true, because this time I want to export my service. This is enabled, so use enable true. Lastly, mention the permission. So for this, I'm gonna create a custom permission. So for that, use here permission, give the name. So I'm using here Gaur Himansu permission.access. And also I want to pass the protection level, which is normal. Now use the same permission over here. Okay, now in this, I'm gonna use here intent filter. In this intent filter, we have action. In the name, we have to mention the path of our interface. So just copy this package, come back to your Android manifest, paste in here, again go back, copy the interface name, come back to your Android manifest and paste in here. So this is my name. Now it's time to execute this application because we are pretty much done with the server app. So it is executing. Now it's time to begin with our client application. So this is my client app, and in this, first thing first, I'm gonna take permission. Permission is Gaur Himanshu permission access. And next I'm gonna mention my queries. So in this query, I will mention my package name, which is this one. All right, so go to your main activity, and in this main activity on the top, I'm gonna create a private wall variable naming service connection. Use your object service connection. In this, we have two functions, on service connected, on service disconnected. So if our service got connected, then I will just typecast my binder into my AIDL interface. But for that, we require that interface in this project. So let's create that. Just right click on it, new AIDL file, name is same. Click on finish. And make sure the package structure is same that we were using in our server. So here we are having AIDL client, but in our server we have AIDL app. So just rename this thing, current only. Convert this thing into AIDL app. Alright, so we are done here. Now in this section, I'm gonna create one more package, and the package name is exactly same, AIDL app. In this, I'm gonna create a class, and the class name is dummy. This is a data class. Wall name type is string, wall age type is int, not intent, it's int. And also use here parcelable interface, and on the top use parcelize annotation. Okay, so now go to your AIDL interface, remove everything, go to your server app one more time, open up AIDL interface, just copy this stuff, go back to your client and paste in here. On the top, mention the parcelable data class, which is dummy. All right, so yeah, now go back to your main activity, and in this service connection, just typecast your P1 as my AIDL interface. Just change the package from AIDL client to AIDL app, which is this one. Now here I'm going to use a logd AIDL dot calculate, and I want to calculate 4-3 sum. Just below to it, I'm having one more logd, and this time I'm gonna perform the transformation. So AIDL dot transformation, pass the dummy. Now in this dummy, name is Himanshu and my age is 24. Just stringify this tag and change the name. Copy the same name and paste in here too. Okay, so yeah, we are done with our on service connected. Now it's time to connect with our service, which is present in our server application. So let's create intent. And in this intent, let me just import this thing. In this intent, we have to pass our action. So go to your Android manifest. This is our action that we have already mentioned in our server application. Let me show you. So this is our server app. Go to the manifest. This is our action. You can see over here. So in this, if you go to the service, this is our action. So simply copy this action, come back to your client app. And in the client app main activity intent, just pass it. Next, we have to set up the package. So in the package, just copy this thing because this is my package and paste in here. Lastly, it's time to bind our service. Bind service, pass your intent, next the service connection, and lastly the flag, which is bind auto create. And once our activity got destroyed, then simply unbind from that service. Alright, so we are pretty much done with our client application. We have a problem in here. Let me check why we are giving. Okay, just leave it. Now it's time to execute our application. Okay, so our application is executing, but eventually it got crashed. Let me check why it is crashing. Okay, so here we are having a problem of class cast exception. So this is the problem. We can't directly typecast our binder interface into iMyAIDL interface. Instead of this, we will use iMyBinder interface stub.as interface, and in this we will pass our binder. Now I'm going to re-execute my application. Okay, so let's see the locket. So in the bottom we receive this 7, which is 4 plus 3 is equivalent to 7, and this is our dummy transformation name Himanshu. So I did pass here Himanshu, now it will become Himanshu transformation, and age is 42, which is 24 plus 18. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you got an idea what is the use case of AIDL interface and how you can use these interfaces to share the functionality of your server application to other application. So yeah, we will meet in our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, very goodbye.